like salt dissolves in water.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
The Christians who claim to be following Jesus will have to accept Islam at this point, the ones who are alive at that time, because he will say to them, if you want to follow me, you have to follow Muhammad.
As a Christian, I don't believe that Jesus is going to declare himself to be a Muslim. And I mean, that's going to be a bone of contention, I think, between Muslims and Christians.
Even as we speak in Medina, in Saudi Arabia, next to the grave, the resting place of Muhammad, peace be on him, right next to that is an empty space reserved for Jesus.
The Islamic understanding of the Second Coming that you often hear Muslims talk about, Jesus coming, wearing white robes, ascending in Damascus, breaking the cross, killing every pig, is all grown up, fictionally, I would probably say, a case of fiction and legends and later stories.
People who tell these stories to each other, all their names and details about their lives were actually recorded so that people could tell the difference between liars and people with bad memories from those with very good memories, and who are reliable storytellers, if you like, or transmitters of the hadith.
Not all Muslims and Christians see themselves in disagreement. Adam Williamson and Jamie Clark are good friends. Adam is a Muslim and Jamie is a Christian. Despite having different views on Jesus, they often find common ground.
You know, I could get into a lot of trouble for saying this, but I do think that there's a lot of truth, you know, about Jesus in the Quran. I'm not looking for where they contradict each other, I'm looking for where they don't contradict each other, because that's where the truth is, I feel. But that doesn't mean, for me, that I have to be a Muslim. The Christian truth is still very deep in my heart.
One of the things that I love about Islam, I really love this, is that God has set up all of these meta-narratives. Like, the Christians have their version of reality, the Jews have their version of reality, the Buddhists have their version of reality, the Muslims have their version of reality, the secularists, atheists, have their version of reality. And all of these are talked about in the Quran, all these different realities. And then the Quran says, you better think about these. Think deeply about these. Don't just assume that these are correct. You have to think, you have to use your brain.
There's a quote in the Quran, which a lot of Christians have difficulty with, which is, be not a friend to Christian or Jew. And that's, you know, that's so easy to kind of take completely the wrong way, but maybe if you look at it a little bit deeper, I mean, it reflects something about, maybe it's just saying accept your differences, you know, accept your differences and be.
It takes a certain amount of arrogance for me to go to Jamie and start telling him he's, you know, he's going on the wrong path, and vice versa. You know, it's not my place. You know, we've got to admit, you know, to a certain extent, we're all fumbling around, you know, looking for some form of truth.
I invite you to accept Islam, because the difference between me and you, I do the prayer that the Prophet Muhammad did, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I recite the same as he recited. I have the same movements, I have the same prayers. But the Christians do not have the prayer that Jesus had.
I think it's profoundly important that Muslims follow the Christian version of Jesus. Firstly, because Jesus claimed about himself that that it was how you responded to him that determined how God would judge you and where your future lay. And my concern for Muslims is they're following a Jesus who is a non-historical Jesus. They need to get back to the original, to his message, and what he said about himself.
The Prophet Muhammad's most important concern in engaging people that were hostile to him was how I can turn this enemy into a friend. And that only comes from love. that comes from a concern. And I think the centrality of love in the Christian tradition is a very beautiful quality. And it's something that many Muslims have forgotten about their own faith. And I think there's an immense amount that Muslims can learn from Jesus. I also think there's an immense amount that Christians can learn from Muhammad.
Has democracy been stifled rather than spread in Latin American countries? Filmmaker John Pilger argues that it has in the documentary War on Democracy, tomorrow night on ITV1 at 11. The Vicar's Wives prepare for Easter next this evening, then looking at the different religions of the world. This week, Essentials of Faith investigates Judaism. That's at 12:45.